Знаешь, как бы это характер, что ты идешь дальше, не сдаешься. Поэтому да, тогда я была такая, а сейчас я более спокойная, потому что все окей, мне все нравится.
Такая ты settled.
Да, да, потому что даже то, что я, может быть, я вот никогда не мечтала, у меня не было в мечтах попасть в финал, этого не было. У меня была просто мечта найти партнера, с которым ты будешь понимать друг друга и наслаждаться процессом тренировочным, поездки, то все. Оно привело, видишь, куда. Mm-hmm. То есть эта мечта уже пришла в процессе. Думаю, блин, а можно будем еще финал сделаем? А вдруг так получится, да. Поэтому оно пришло во время вот аппетита, во время еды.
Это классно. Я просто Ире говорю, что я очень респект то, что она вот про разные свои лайфстейджес может открыто говорить. Потому что мы с Кристиной поэтому и обсуждаем это все, что очень часто, ну типа, всю жизнь я примерная. Ну зачем ты рассказываешь? Ну мы же все знаем, что это не так.
Нет, я вот Ане говорю, я не такая. Меня как раз многие знают, когда я была другая, сумасшедшая. Вот, и как бы, и, может быть, из-за этого, мне кажется, ну может быть, это я почувствовала в разговоре, Саша боялся жениться на мне. Потому что он знал меня с другой стороны, сумасшедшей, бешеной, неадекватной, но не в смысле...
Ты не боишься, что это вернется? Вот это?
Нет, нет, потому что если но надо...
Это же все равно как бы inner, да, inner side.
Если там, например, вот, рассматривая тот вариант где-нибудь потусить, повеселиться, это все равно остается, когда ты в кругу своей компании, где ты себя чувствуешь комфортно. Mm-hmm. Да, например, вот сейчас пойти в какой-нибудь клуб, где люди, которых я не знаю, там отрываться мне уже не хочется так. Потому что все равно, ну, люди на тебя посмотрят странно, что пришла там своими волосами наматывать, знаешь, метелками.
А это было тоже, может быть, ты прожила это уже часть, это как бы неинтересно, знаешь, это как...
Я уже попробовала, мне уже неинтересно, ну и было так классно. Сейчас бы вот мне, если там как-то повеселиться, вернуться в то ощущение вот этой бешеной меня, только хочу с друзьями, где ты можешь попрыгать, покричать, поплясать, так что никто тебя уже знает, да, никто тебя, знаешь, там не осудит, не скажут, девушка, выйдите, пожалуйста, как бы не в адеквате вы немножко.
So we started already to talk about it before. Can you please give us a little bit more information on that? Why were you dancing?
Okay, first of all, I started to dance when I was 4 years old. I think at that time I was just in love in dancing because of my sister. Every time I look how she walk, how she dance, how she come from dancing lessons, happy and beautiful. So on that age, I think I was just in love watching her and I just want to copy everything what she's doing. And then slowly, I realized I love dancing more than anything because I had a choice. I was playing piano, I was doing sport aerobics and ballet and dancing. So my parents at a certain point they said, okay, you have to choose. Mm-hmm. I choose only two first. So I choose ballet and dancing, ballroom dancing. But then they said, okay, you have to move forward. So you have to choose now from these two. It was, I think, after maybe 1 year. And both, I had both chances to go to St. Petersburg for a ballet school. I was at that time maybe 8 or 7 and choose dancing. But I need to stay in Siberia with my parents because I loved dancing so much and so much freedom than ballet at that time. I chose dancing.
And now watching at your dancing past and analyzing your past, was there any teacher who really shaped you as a dancer and helped you to establish, not in the results, but in the as a dancer, as a female dancer?
My teachers, not really. I had a little bit difficulty in the beginning because no one wanted to take me for the class. I was too loud, I was not concentrated, so I was always a little bit difficult kid.
Doesn't match with the picture that we see now.
I learned so much, but yeah, I had difficulty to start the classes. So most of the teachers, they're refusing me.
And even later on, like when you was already dancing with Alex, maybe in the age
even
that you was already.
Years, yeah, maybe something changed in your mind, some teacher.
No, actually, it was everything normal, smooth, no, nothing outstanding.
So little by little?
Yes, step by step, yeah. No, no, something like extending, yeah.
And in your partnership as a dance partnership, not in family, but when you were actively competing, who was responsible for the decision making in the couple?
Alex.
Alex.
Yes.
So which competition you do, with whom you have lessons, yes. What couple is doing, it was everything Alex. And you trusted that?
Yes, for 100%. We are very similar for decision or anything. So it was easy, very easy to match what he wants or what I want. Mm-hmm. Of course, we had certain plan we have to talk about. So what we can do together, what you want, what I want. But the end decision is always him.
And as now you're already retired. And I think, actually, are you retired?
Not yet.
Because, yeah, you had that, but there never was this official retirement
announcement.
Yeah. I think everything now postponed, right? So the situation in the world makes everybody a little bit like, hold on, yeah? Mm-hmm. So, of course, after birth, I want to come back to dance competition and mostly show. But we actually decide, okay, let's wait. Now not the time to announce because actually I'm slowly getting back in shape. But if I really miss competition, if you ask me, not at all. I don't miss practicing stamina. I don't miss preparation before the competition. I just love and miss dancing. So if I go to the studio, I fully dance myself without any rules, restriction. I just go for it. And I think that's why I don't really want to go at the moment to compete. I need a little bit time to understand what I want if I come back.
So then the question, I will change it in a different way. I planned on one side, now I will change it. As before pandemic, yeah? Why do you think, because for me, honestly, I talk only for myself. I always watch ballroom, I love ballroom. And when I watched the final, for me you were the very charismatic, very artistic, and very interesting to watch couple. You know, like mm-hmm. to Latin world and ballroom world. For many people say that the ballroom maybe sometimes is quite similar. The couples have not outstanding, but you were outstanding.
Especially
always for me.
Especially if you don't understand ballroom really
yes,
well.
Yes, especially yeah. When you don't understand ballroom as well. And for me, you were always outstanding. And I never understood why you didn't have higher results, honestly. So what do you think, why you actually never achieved before pandemic to be first?
All right, so there's two things, feeling-wise, what we feel, and I think the second is what the people saying why we can't make it higher place. As you know, in our dancing world, nothing is only about dancing, right? And I think, well, I speak very honest and open on your project, yeah. Well, there is a few things. First of all, people say, because we start dancing with Alex in professional, so we don't have pedigree, we don't have background from the amateur career. So we will be always lower place than the people who already have it. And then some people, like teachers, let's say, yeah, and judges, they saying to your face. So you know why don't appreciate, they don't give you higher place. And then second of all, there is a queue, which people also speak about quite open. So you have to respect the queue. You are young guys, you came later than anyone, and you didn't have amateur career before you're professional. So you will wait. But sometimes people are wrong that we're young.
That's why I wanted to talk about it. I think everyone talking about it, it's okay. Just. Yeah. Yeah, so, let's be honest.
To hear that into your face when you have lesson or when you speak to someone really, respectful, yeah. It's a bit shame. You feel like, why are you saying that? Like you are actually telling the secret. At least we know, we understand, but don't tell this to us. Mm-hmm. Because you feel a little bit like it's hurting you. So no matter what you do, you try to find choreography, you're practicing, you try to... bring something on
because you know you deserved it
yes.
And they say that
and
you didn't make it because of that
yeah they said guys you're dancing really good we love it you look different from the others but you have to wait you have to respect the cue and this I think the worst thing when dancer can hear it because then why I have to try so hard and spend my life my heart my years yeah to do that if you will be still in the same cue But a sad thing, which actually we watch and notice for the past 5 years, we are actually in that circle. We were in that queue for 5 years. Mm-hmm. We are moving up. It's great. We are super happy. We really grateful to anything happening, yeah, for the people who support, but we're still in that queue. So we never had a chance to get on the top of someone in the front. Yeah, and one very funny thing, which again I said, I'm quite organized, and 2015, yes, I had note and I write down a plan for the future, 5-3 years plan. Mm-hmm. And I like it, it's like a game. So I tried to, I put the names in the recent final, it was 2016. And I tried to analyze how many years each couple will stay, how many years couple will dance, what is the chance and then possibilities for us in the next 3-5 years. I did it actually in airplane after one of the biggest competitions. And you can't believe it. We did last com Blackpool 2019. Everything exactly the same what I write it down. So nothing has changed. So someone get retired, the final move up. Someone stopped without retirement and then final get up. So actually it was a little bit like, you know what is going to be. Are you ready to be there for that amount of years, or you want to move on and try something else?
That's very sad, no?
Very sad. Yes, very sad.
Do you think it there is any possibility to change it?
Okay, now people maybe may hate me. I think you have chance to change it in some competitions in the world, but not in UK. I think that's very sad, because I always dream to go to Blackpool, mm-hmm. and I achieve some result which actually can change my future life or something. But actually I was disappointed because it never happened. For us, the first progressive final was international, when actually you didn't expect. Everyone said, you have chance in Blackpool, you can get one dance, two dance, da da da. But no, it never happened. So I get really upset and disappointed with the best comp in the world. It was Blackpool. So every time I went there, I felt like, okay, it's gonna be the same. Or okay, I'm gonna do my maximum, I will enjoy myself more, because in the end it will be about the same. And actually this is what's happened during all of my dancing career. No surprises for Blackpool. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and comps like world championship, it surprised me. So we suddenly get to the final and we get fifth. Actually, we were just happy to be there in the final, but we get higher place than we expect. And the same international. So, yeah.
But not Blackpool.
Not Blackpool. And some people said that's my favorite, I'm looking forward to Blackpool. Not me. Yeah, not me.
Давайте это вот сделаем.
Давай. Который час? Мы же успели.
Ну нормально, мы быстро идем. Да. Поэтому сделаем. Давай закончим уже блок.
Рассказал, у нас даже тональность голоса.
А можно мне еще пару вопросов спрошу ее?
Я тоже хочу, да, потому что я не ожидала, что ты об этом скажешь.
Да мне уже пофиг, честно. А что делать, знаешь, вот люди верят в какую-то сказку, ее нет. Нам на уроках говорят в лицо, вы не заслужили, мы вас не можем поставить выше, выше там пары, которые перед нами стоят.
То же самое сказали.
Да просто, знаешь, как бы ты послушаешь, думаешь, что я тебе сделал.
Кто, вы с WDSF пришли? Вот и ждите дальше.
Она говорит, ребята, вы в аматерах где были? Мы говорим, в разных партнерах. Ну так а что вы хотите? Вы уже довольны должны быть, что вы в финал попали.
Ну я вообще, вот все, что Ира сказала, я в шоке сейчас сижу.
Да, ну блин, это так, прикинь, Ань. Когда просто ты это слышишь на уроке, в лицо, ты думаешь, что да, я сейчас соберу манатки, я уйду с этого урока.
Конечно.
Но надо как бы себя собрать в кучу, думаешь, ладно, все, это делаю для своего блага, потому что я хочу. Да, да, пофиг уже на место, думаю, просто топим и все, как хотим.
Ну просто в конце концов это чисто танцевально для своей души и наслаждаться.
Хочешь, выходи. Поэтому мы решили играть в эту игру.
Но теперь мне становится понятно, просто я не буду сейчас это говорить, потому что у нас дальше вопрос. Но мне становится понятно, очень многие теперь... Все, я потом скажу, понимаю, что да, мне становится.
Либо ты играешь, либо не играешь. Мы в какой-то момент тоже подумали, тогда зачем мы стараемся туда-сюда, мотаемся. Там. Можно же просто прийти,
да,
как бы.
Потом, вот, да, после ты, да, там,
а потом
ездить, брать уроки, постараться. Да. Ну все, до свидания, да. Полуфинал даже.
Да, да, поэтому у нас просто была. Да, у нас просто была тактика бахать все турниры, потому что люди просто должны были нас видеть чаще, чтобы это лицо прям постоянно было, все империал. Да, да. Потому что они просто не понимали, откуда же мы взялись. Да, ребята неплохо танцуют, хорошо, даже можно бы их спокойно, знаешь, как бы. Они нас придерживали в полуфинале, потому что просто у нас нет педигри. Вот они называют педигри. Бэкграунд, типа. Да. То есть
типа
все
педигри, как наш экзамен в школе.
Подготовительные. Да, просто. Да. И поэтому пары, которые приходили, там, первое место аматеров, они сразу бонусом проходили финал, а мы стояли на 7-8. Вот. А второй, конечно, момент, когда вот почему не дают перепрыгнуть, да, на какой-нибудь там выше кого-то, то что они же уже там долго стоят на этом месте, как сейчас кто-то их перепрыгнет. Очередь. Вот ты стоишь в очереди, ждешь.
Да, когда тебе это вообще на уроке говорят, это капец.
Ты окей, Сань?
Мы, знаешь, когда после турниров автопати там какой-нибудь идешь там к педагогу, там спрашиваешь, ну как, вы танцевали очень хорошо, ребят, просто вот танцуйте, как танцевали. Мое место это ничего не значит. Знаешь, там кто-нибудь из педагогов, который тебя постоянно на турнирах судит, и хорошего
да.
мнения, отношения, и комменты хорошие, ты думаешь, ну почему ты мне такое место даешь?
Да, да, да.
Мы же хорошо танцевали. Он говорит, ребят, я просто не могу, потому что все присутствуют, и я не могу вам дать лучшее место.
И даже потом с него, типа.
Да, и как бы даже не думайте, что я там где-то вас просудил, потому что вы плохо станцевали. Вы станцевали, там вот было на ежитуре, очень хорошо. Просто так же все делаете, ничего не меняете. Просто мы не можем сейчас вам взять и вот так вот вперед от этого. Этот же тоже так, как вы ходили, занимали, заслуживали свою очередь. Ты же думаешь, да пошли все, знаешь, думаешь. Думаем, будем делать то, что хотим мы. Поэтому, как бы, это может быть ваш следующий вопрос, не знаю. Но поэтому, как бы, был такое, знаешь, решение. А хотим мы дальше продолжать стоять в этой очереди. То есть четвертое мы бахнули в Блэкпуле. Да? Ну, как бы, давай я тогда сейчас расскажу, да, потому что это тоже, знаешь, момент, когда думают, как вы решились там на ребенка, а как, а что, стоять в очереди вот так вот, у меня как бы годы тикают тоже, я не хочу там, знаешь, потерять этот шанс, потому что это все ближе и ближе к риску.
Да, те, которые вот стоят в очереди, многие и не могут забеременеть потом.
И потом думаешь, ну окей, я сделаю сегодня четвертое, завтра третье, но это мою жизнь поменять может совсем кардинально, если я сейчас возьму и сделаю ребенка. Надо, вернусь. Ну что там сделать, к четвертому подобраться, уроков поднабрал, да и все. Форму себя привел, нагонял квикстеп, и все.
Ну
так-то, да?
То
есть это так, да, да, да. То есть если даже мы сейчас придем, все равно мы уже имеем приоритет перед теми парами, кто сейчас стоит в полуфинале. Их чуть сдвинут с хвоста, нам дадут пройти. То есть сейчас уже мы в такой же ситуации, что мы уже застолбили этот финал, и мы уже считаемся финалистами. Придет время, и тебе скажут по добру пожаловать, если это надо. Но я не очень пока готова. Я не хочу в эту кашу возвращаться.
Конечно, тем более после ребенка, мне кажется, после baby birth вообще по-другому.
Я представляю, что сейчас мне нужно эти часы все направить на уроки, на поездку, на ребенка с кем-то оставить. Я так хотела, чтобы он впитал мое воспитание, потому что у меня, я говорю, четкое есть. Так и не вот никак иначе. Поэтому я не представляю, как я его кому-то оставлю, а потом буду жалеть, что я его не научила тому-то, тому-то. Или он меня не слушается в пол взгляда.
Потому что я пошла и захотела стать третьей.
Да, вот, да. Я думаю, а нужно ли это, что я недовольна?
Да,
то есть здесь нужно как бы, да, если я готова на это, я буду так делать. Если не готова, наверное, я бы дальше танцевала.
Окей, you mentioned this kind of cue. Yes, that we are standing in some of the couples. So, and you said that you are not retired. So do you think that you will be able to come back and stay in this queue again? Do you actually want it or not?
I don't want to stay in the queue because I think we can do much more with Alex as a couple. But maybe I will change my mind in a few years. Maybe I will come back and then said, okay, I want to get back to that game and play again. But I know the rules. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so before we danced the last Blackpool, of course, it was a little bit like a way to find the rule how to play that game. Now I know that game and I can play, and I play very clever. But there is a decision. I think if I really want or I don't want, I don't know yet. I need to decide in a few years.
And what will be your advice to the young generation? Because of course, if they will watch this, they will say, okay, why I should, like you said, why I should work hard, why I should go practice, and why, if there is this kind of things happening, yeah, in our dancing world. Mm-hmm. Why you were still dancing? Why you didn't finish up before? Why you said, okay, yeah, I will not fight anymore because it will not change anything?
Yeah, I think because I wanted to push myself as a dancer more forward as long as I can. So I have a different stages before, like I was a bit lazy sometimes, but I just want to practice ballroom. And some stages when I had a goal to get to a higher place and discover myself as a dancer, then I start to do more things, not just a dancing practice, cardio preparation, put myself on diet, researching for the style I want to produce for in a dancing dancing floor, dancing area, in ballroom dancing, yeah? I'm not talking about Latin. I think I was always trying to find myself more and more. And that's why I didn't stop. I never think about result. And in the beginning, when we start dancing with Alice, we actually never think about make some dancing career, like a dancer in the final or being a top dancer. We just want to find a good partners for each other, like that's why I found Alex. We can understand each other, we can talk to each other and work together, the partners, professional partners, without any stupid mistakes or problems or argument. So in the beginning,
you can just enjoy with this person the process.
Exactly. So I was always looking for partner who understand me and let myself to develop more as a dancer, give me the freedom to become a good dancer. And I think Alex also needs someone just like a supporting person. So support him with any idea, allowed him to do more. Mm-hmm. So yes, actually also in our couple was everything very clear from the beginning because we had conversation before we start dancing. And we both decide not to do competitions. That was the main idea. We're gonna start dancing together, but just for shows, for some events. So we're not going to do competition. And we say to each other that like a few times, we're not going to compete. I said, no, I don't want to compete. He said, me too. Just to make clear, we're not going for the competition. I said, okay, we are clear. I don't want to compete. I don't want to have any lesson with a teacher for, let's say, politics. When we actually find that our tryout went so well, we decided to have a second opinion. So that moment was Amanda Dockman in the studio, and we said, okay, let's have one lesson, just to have an opinion. So we had one lesson, and then she said, so guys, when is your competition? And we both like, we're not going to compete. She said, what? Why are you dancing together then? You have to feel like you are going to do something like more than just practice. And then so we dance together just to earn money. We're gonna go for the shows and some events to perform, but no competition. She said, no, you can't do that. So actually she pushed us. She said, you must go. And then she find the comp in Shenzhen, the one in the summertime, July. Mm-hmm. You have to go there. We said, no, we're not going. She said, yes. I said, yes, you must. Actually, that was our first comp.
So Amanda pushed you in that direction, actually.
Yeah, she said you have
thanks
to go.
Thanks to Amanda. If not, we will not know you as a dancer. Yes. And you will not be such a great example for so many people.
Yeah. So, and then of course she said great words. She said, guys, okay, you are thinking very limited. You think here. You have to think a bit more open. You have talent. You can go. You can discover yourself as a dancer. Don't stop there because you need to earn, so you're going to do only shows and you're going to practice in the studio. It's actually, you don't go from there anywhere. You will just stop developing as a dancer. So you must have competition because this is like, you know, proof test. You prove it, you made it, you did all your practices, then you must go to the competition.
So for example, what I'm reading a little bit now between the lines is that the actual place on the competition, because of that cue and things that you mentioned before, and then the development and how you was finding yourself as a dancer, that you just wanted to understand your depth as a dancer, yes, how much you can do. Yeah. And that the competition is like a lacmus paper to see if the work is going on.
Yes.
What I'm going with this is, you are dancing purely to develop yourself. And the actual competition is not, and the result on the competition is not the achievement that you put the medal on your chest and you're like, yes, I have done it.
This is coming after the prize presentation. That feeling, yeah, when I'm like, okay, during the comp normally, we just go there to enjoy it first, find that feeling of enjoyment. But if you're a competitor, you also have a little bit of...
Hunger,
yes, and a little bit of, yeah, not worry, but how can I say, excitement. That excitement, yeah, a little bit of adrenaline in yourself, so you can't really enjoy straight away from the first moment. Well, I normally feel that feeling of enjoyment somewhere in between, in the middle of the comp. So for me, the first round, it goes a little bit like, okay, I have to find myself, I have to find audience, I have to feel it. Then, after we finish the comp, dancing area, dancing part, then when the non prize presentation, and then say, okay, now we can think about what is going to be, mm-hmm. yeah, what is the result?
Right. I mean, in the long term, not just one competition, but how to find motivation for yourself in all that situation that you have been. What I see, I don't know, I want you to approve or disapprove what I understood from this conversation, that you found your motivation purely inside yourself, not by being rewarded from any marks of the competition or any results. You was finding motivation to get further and further just because you wanted to improve yourself. Yes. Is this correct?
Yes, and I think I didn't really maximize myself yet. So that's why this thought, I will come back or I don't come back, or I will redirect my feelings, my dancing ability in the show. I don't know yet, because yes, this is what I do. I'm trying to look at myself as much as I can. I know many dancers, they hate to watch videos, but I hate also sometimes look at myself, but I do it because I know that I'm the only one who find my personal style and what I would like to improve. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm very critical. I love to really go deeper in what I did wrong, not necessarily what I did right. Yeah, but I actually like to look much more deeper in what I'm doing during the dancing. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so.
And what about, for example, we talked about ballroom, yeah? Mm-hmm. Or what about Latin? Do you think that the Latin world is different in any aspects than ballroom, or they're same?
You mean dancing-wise or result-wise?
In all the aspects.
I think it's about the same. It's about the same, and what?
Because I heard some my friends ballroom dancers. Yeah, they say yeah, but in Latin you have this and that. It's much better than in ballroom. Ballroom we are more restricted. We are, you know, we are more under pressure. Some of the people think so. They feel that the Latin dancer we have more freedom and we are judged more, there is this thing.
I think in ballroom it's more about comparison. They try to compare with someone ahead of you. Mm-hmm. But this is, I think, from my point of view, it's a big problem because each couple must be very individual with a personal style. We cannot compare champion, second, third, fourth, and then make all of them the same. And they said, okay, now I can see they're not the same as the first one. They shouldn't be the same. So this is, I think, this is what's happened, I think, in the ballroom.
Yes.
I feel that, okay, if you come with a different style in the ballroom, and some people, they don't want to accept it, and you're going to stay away from top three, top four, top six, let's say, because you are different. Mm-hmm. So you have to make everything routine and style a little bit similar to those couple, yeah, then you can come closer. And I think that's how the judge is killing personality of each dancer. And that's how sometimes the couple who is really creative and different stay in semi-final or quarter-final for too long. They just don't have a chance with their own personality to go forward and be different in that kind of group. Yeah, and that's why I think sometimes people say ballroom is boring. It's because too many couples are similar to each other. And if they do something different, even routine-wise, they've been criticized. Yeah, so they don't have someone to support. Okay, do it differently. It's okay, maybe you're not perfectly lined up, but you are more cool, you're more interesting, you have more drama in dancing, you have more actions, yeah, no, they will be criticized because you're not the same as the first, second, and third, let's say, yeah? Mm-hmm. So that's why you will stay away. You are not part of these three.
To be myself is real. Baby is a new life and happiness. To be persistent is follow your goal. Love is understanding between two people.
I watch TV.
I don't like when the people lie. Men think he is the leader of the family. Back in 2001, I don't remember what happened then. I apologize if I did something wrong. If my partner is upset with me, I try to apologize.